Hi everyone, in this Ivanti video we're going to look at how Ivanti Neurons Patch for Intune works and what the steps are in setting it up. Intune is Microsoft's cloud-based endpoint management system. Of particular interest to us today is its ability to deploy applications to devices either as required, forcing deployment of the application to devices, or as available, making them optionally available through a company portal. This includes the deployment of updates or patches to installed applications. Ivanti Neurons Patch for Intune extends Intune to include risk-based third-party patch publishing and provides a single interface to manage your patching. You can deploy third-party updates alongside Microsoft operating system and application updates within Intune as part of your existing application lifecycle management workflows. Before we really get started, a little note. I am a technical communicator for Ivanti, so I am no expert in the Microsoft side of things and have no forewarning of when Microsoft are about to make changes to their software. For this reason, please refer to the Microsoft documentation for details about using Intune in Azure. And also please refer to the Ivanti Neurons documentation for the latest details of how to use Patch for Intune. Sometimes we need to make changes to the software, and it is easier and quicker for me to update the online documentation than to update this video. Right, let's get started. We need a starting point, and to avoid this video getting too long, we're going to say that you can already sign into your Ivanti Neurons platform tenant and have Microsoft Intune set up and running. You're also going to need some roles. Check the Neurons documentation in case Microsoft had made any changes, but in fall 2023, you need either the Entra ID role Intune Administrator or both the Intune role Application Manager and the Entra ID role Global Reader. Remember, Entra ID is the new name for what used to be Azure Active Directory or Azure AD. When you first start Patch for Intune, a welcome dialog appears that guides you through the setup process. When you have completed the setup, the dialog reappears only when new features have been added that require further setup. There is a help button that links to the relevant place in the Ivanti documentation. When you're ready, click Get Started. The first thing we need to do is to create a secure method for Ivanti Neurons to communicate with Intune. We do this by creating an app registration in the Entra ID section of your Azure portal. Remember to check the Microsoft documentation for the latest information about all of this. Give the app registration a name. Leave the supported account type set to single tenant. We'll come back to the redirect URI later, so for now, just click Register. Now we need some permissions. Click API permissions, then click Add a permission. The Request API permissions panel appears. We want Microsoft Graph permissions, and first we will set some delegated permissions. See the help for details in case they have had to change. Then we need to add some application permissions. Again, check the help. After we have an app registration in Azure, click Next on the Welcome dialog, and you will see the value for the redirect URI that we skipped earlier. The redirect URI is a destination that Azure returns authentication responses to. You can also find this value in the Patch for Intune settings under Admin. Copy the redirect URI, switch to Azure, then click Authentication and add a platform. In the Configure Platforms panel, click Single Page Application, then paste the URI you copied into the Redirect URI field and click Configure. Next, we need to create the Intune credentials in Ivanti Neurons that will be used for publishing applications to Intune. Click Neurons Credentials to open the Neurons Credentials page in a new tab. Click Add Credentials and in the drop-down select Microsoft Intune, then click Next. Enter a suitable name and a description to help you to identify this in future. Now we need to copy some information from your Azure portal into the Neurons credentials. From the overview page for your app in Azure, copy the directory tenant ID and paste it into the tenant ID. Then copy the application client ID into the client ID. Back in Azure, switch to the Certificates and Secrets page and add a new secret. Copy the value of the secret and paste it into the Client Secret field on the Credentials page in Neurons, then click Submit. The credential is saved. The next step is to connect to the credentials we just created by selecting them in the Azure Credentials list and clicking Connect. You can also do this on the Patch for Intune Settings page. You are almost set up. There is one more thing we'll cover in this video, and then there are a few other items that may also be available that are covered in the documentation. The final step we're going to cover in this video is to authenticate your browser session to connect it to your Intune account. Click Authenticate. A pop-up window appears. Select the account you use with Azure, then enter your password and click Sign In. Your browser session is authenticated with Azure, and the account you just signed in with is used to communicate with Intune. All users will sometimes see a banner at the top of the window telling them that their Azure browser session has expired and that they need to re-authenticate, along with a button to do this. The frequency of this appearing depends on your Entra ID session length and your browser's environment. If you want to sign out of Azure, you can do this on the Patch for Intune Settings page, where you can also select a specific scope in Intune if you have the Intune Administrator account and you use scopes in Intune. This is the next page on the Welcome dialog, and there is a separate video about this subject. There's a link in the description. The remaining pages of the Welcome dialog help you to distribute the Ivanti code signing certificate and create an Intune connector for Neurons so that you can see additional details about your software and devices in Ivanti Neurons. See the help for more information about those topics and any others that may get added to the Welcome Dialog. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please give it the thumbs up and remember to subscribe to our channel to see more videos like this about all of our products. Thanks for watching.